It's everywhere. The grocery store, your favorite clothing store, on the TV. Green marketing.
Eco-friendly products.
It's a reusable makeup towel.
And it's better for the environment.
Consumers can't get enough. Conscious consumption in the name of sustainability is on the rise, and companies have taken note. But some eco-friendly labels are misleading or even false. This type of deceptive advertising is known as greenwashing. Greenwashing can be found anywhere, from the cars you drive to the pillows where you rest your head. In one of the biggest greenwashing cases back in 2016, Volkswagen and Porsche paid over $9.5 billion to customers after the Federal Trade Commission sued over misleading green claims, including the marketing of Volkswagen-branded and Audi-branded cars as clean diesel. Take one of those ads, for example.
No, listen to me, Terry. Diesel in Latin means dirty.
I'll prove it to you.
You're gonna ruin your scarf. Oh, look what she's doing.
See how clean it is?
Here, a woman shows the Volkswagen's car's diesel is so clean that it can't stain her pristine white scarf. The FTC alleged Volkswagen's ad campaign falsely claimed the cars were low emission and environmentally friendly. In reality, the cars were fitted with illegal emission defeat devices, designed to mask high emissions during government tests, according to the FTC. The companies did not admit or deny the allegations, but agreed to pay the multi-billion dollar settlement. More recently, the FTC and DOJ sued Kohl's and Walmart for marketing several textile products as bamboo made under eco-friendly processes when they were actually made of rayon. Producing rayon involves using toxic chemicals and emitting hazardous pollutants, the FTC and DOJ said. The companies did not admit or deny the allegations, but agreed to pay a combined total of $5.5 million. Since 1992, the FTC has brought around 90 cases against companies, alleging violations of the FTC's environmental marketing guidelines. So why is greenwashing so rampant?
The reason that it's done is because it's so profitable.
And companies are aware. In a survey of around 1,500 business executives, more than half said their organization overstated their sustainability efforts. Two-thirds question how genuine some of their organization's sustainability efforts were. What can you do as a consumer? In the short term, Jones recommends labels like B Corp or Fair Trade on products. Guides like Better World Shopper can help people keep track of a company's record. But Jones says the solution can't fall on the consumer alone.
What frustrates me the most is when people say, well, it's really important to do your homework, do your research. You know, everybody should do the research. Because you know what? You can't do your research. It's impossible. You're going up against some of the most powerful companies in the world with some of the highest paid PR campaigns. And it's just you with your computer. There's no way you're going to navigate that space.
Instead, Jones says to focus on the bigger issue, pressuring lawmakers to hold companies accountable.
Contact your local politicians or your state or your federal politicians and ask them for things like more transparency and more accountability. You want to see what they're doing so that you can make a choice. The more data we have, the better. And it has to be practical data. And then you also need accountability. So if suddenly the worst greenwashers are fined X million dollars for every time they greenwash, then it becomes not as profitable to greenwash, and it becomes more reasonable to do the right thing.
Early efforts like that are underway to hold the fashion industry accountable. Legislators in New York have proposed the Fashion Act, which will require major fashion brands to disclose and reduce their negative environmental and social impacts. France is expected to require a climate impact label on clothing sold in the country. Jones said he hopes all products will be required to have this kind of label.
To measure things like sustainability, you know, green impact, impact on human beings, wages, you know, anything with human rights. We really need to take stock of this moment, because what we're seeing is consumers are rising up and they are demanding products and services that are doing right by people and the planet and this world.